Well, it's been powder coated. It's been sitting for at least 20 years since powder coating. So I noticed some of the welds, you know, have a little bit of rust that's happening maybe in some of these unfinished areas. When I mean, this has been sitting in my basement or the basements of my homes as we've moved for the past 20 years. Got some extra parts. You know, the engine is never ran that I know of, because when we came into the bike, my good friend Dave, about 25 years ago, 28 years ago, was working at the post office, and this lady said, "Hey, I have this old bike in my garage. If you come and take it, you can have it." And we had no idea what it was. And we really didn't even know what it was when we saw it. I mean, we were 19 years old at the time. So we just took it home. At that time, it was all together. And it was at my friend's house. And I went over there one weekend, and he had disassembled the whole thing.
Oh, my.
And that's how it's been sitting for 25 years. I found some original exhaust for it. Which I have. The whole back of the truck is filled with parts. I have some NOS parts. When eBay first came onto the scene in the early 2000s, we got an NOS gas tank off of eBay. We got NOS fenders off of eBay. We got an NOS airbox off of eBay. So we got some cool stuff. But then I had kids, and that kind of got put on the back burner. And now we're finishing the rec room in our basement, and I just kind of came across all the parts. This is like last year when I talked to you, and I said, I should probably put this together, but it's beyond my ability, especially since I didn't take it apart. Mm-hmm. And so that's why we're here. I put my name on the list. I called, you know, and then you said to call back in April, but COVID was going on. And then I just waited, and I called about a month ago, and you said, "Oh, well, you're next on the list." And I said, "Well, that's convenient."
Well, this is definitely a 75Z1 motor. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah, I looked at the numbers, all match, the swing arm numbers, the frame numbers, and the motor numbers. From what I know about the research I've done, it should all be hanging together. I've got the original wheels. I don't know where the date code is on those. But I think the bike was fairly stock, except it did have a pipe on it, and it had one of those big Corbin seats with the big Queen Bee seat. But other than that, I don't think there was a whole lot done to it, but I don't know. There's a lot of time between 75 and when we came into it.
Let's unload it and take a look.
There are these fork bars. There's some rust starting, and if we're going to go through this much work, I don't want to chintz it. So however it can be fixed, or if it needs to be repowder coated, whatever the best solution is, I just don't want to go through the trouble that you're going to go through and then have it be.
I think we should wipe it off and take a look. If you want it to be perfect, 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 I'd redo it. But if you want, I mean, we can clean that up a little bit, but right on all the seams.
Yeah. I'm thinking, I mean, the more that I look at it, and especially in the sunlight, and the more I see the spots, I'd rather just get it right.
Okay.
Honestly.
In 75, the later bikes, the early ones had holes here, and then they made them solid as they got older. This is a nice pin. This is a nicer frame. They had a crash bar on here at one time.
Yeah, I think they had a big wind jammer and all that fun stuff on there.
Mm-hmm.
Is that something that you can mold in the frame then before it gets filled, to take that little kink out of it?
Yeah. We could braise that and grind it flat. All that stuff if you decide to get rid of it.
I only want a bike.
We'll take it.
Make
all.
One good bike out of all this, and I'm going to be happy. So we'll get some of the stuff in here. So I had the side covers painted. And a guy, Nate, that was Z Resto, who I had do these gauges, also sprayed those for me. So he and it came with, when we got it, these little, so it had a jet kit in it, obviously, and little air cleaners on it.
Okay. Do you want to run stock air box?
I don't know.
Do you have a stock air box?
Yeah, I do.
Wow.
Stock air box.
Wow.
And this is Bob at Z Resto.
Uh-huh.
Sprayed it, and these are the decals for the rear.
Okay.
My wife's a graphic artist.
Oh, is she?
Yeah.
Well, here they are. Hopefully they're
perfect.
And this is a long time ago.
Yeah. I have never seen an NOS air box before.
Still in the bag.
That's my first one I've ever seen.
This is the NOS tank.
Oh, my.
It had,
oh wow,
we sprayed it with clear and there was a little run in there that we wet sanded out, but needs to be buffed out better. But that is,
that's the holy grail,
an unfilled, yeah, that was an eBay purchase that we just jumped on. I mean, it's not perfect, there's a couple scratches and stuff in it, but it's good enough for me.
You gotta have a name for this bike.
Look how beautiful this tank
is. We've always called it the Z1.
The Z1. That's good enough for me. Oh, wow.
That's the holy grail.
Wow. That's cool. Very nice.
So I believe these are off of a 76, just based on the stamps on them.
Yeah, if it says 76.
But still beautiful.
Oh my.
The original fender, but an NOS rear.
Oh man.
And then a couple other, one that's okay.
All right.
So I wouldn't have bought this. So I thought I had an NOS front fender, and as I was pulling it out, I realized it's not for this bike.
You know, this could be nice because there is absolutely no road rash.
So I have this NOS, but I have no idea what it goes to.
It's
not a Z1.
It looks like it's either LTD or a CSR or something like that. It's a part number, a four-digit number. Here's kind of, I'm not an expert, but they came out with four-digit numbers around 77 or 78, the suffix. So it goes to something 79 and up, eight or so. I could find out what it is.
Yeah, it'd be interesting. Obviously, it's not for this bike.
This could be a nice fender.
Okay.
And I'll tell you what I like about this fender here. Well, we'll see how nice these pits are, but the quality
of the original.
Oh yeah,
the thickness of the metal, and
this is 70s quality. The world has changed, unfortunately. Well, you know,
compartments and everything still from the powder coater.
It's like they cut the air box for some odd reason. I don't know why.
We do have another cover from the sissy bar.
Mm-hmm.
So all that's in here. I don't know if you want to unpack that up here. It's a little rough as well. I mean, it's rough in the same spots. Mm-hmm. Around the basement.
Yeah.
In a damp environment. Lots of miscellaneous stuff that we just kind of bought over here. And a headlight. Just got mirrors still with the repos.
Mm-hmm.
Brake pads.
Okay.
I love it.
Got the ear that's a little bit too rusty.
Oh wow, this is a nice part. I'd use the ones without the coating on them.
Okay.
Seat hinges. Yeah, these are nice because it's got the, this is genuine stuff right here. This is nice, that head like that.
Yep. We had every intention of putting it together.
You've got some wonderful parts
over
here.
Over many years. Yeah, I know we did a great job of collecting parts. Now is the hard part. Using them. Pet car.
Oh, yeah. This is some nice stuff.
Rear shocks are down there.
Man, these are nice. Where in the heck did you come up with all this stuff at?
eBay. Over the year. I mean, this is eBay 20 years ago.
See, the shocks are even date coded on the bottom. See that?
Yeah. Is it the right year?
I don't know shocks numbers, because it says 3N. So I'm thinking 3 would be 73 or 74, depending on the month, but A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. I don't want to say for sure, but this is N equals 14.
Okay.
I don't know. Now they, you know, I don't know. Now my mechanic, he's Japanese. Sometimes they had a system called the Emperor system, and I don't know how that works exactly either. But I'll definitely be talking to him about it. That's for sure. This, oh man, another brand new fork here. This is nice stuff.
Yeah, there was a dealership, and this is early 2000s, that was going out of business or consolidating.
Mm-hmm.
And I just, anything that they had on their inventory list that was related to the Z1, I just bought. So that's where some of this miscellaneous stuff came from.
Wow. This has to be one of the nicest basket cases I've ever seen in my life.
It's kind of an interesting basket case in the fact that we've done a lot of the collection already. This is how my buddy took it apart, so I haven't looked at this trash bag, so he just took bolts off and then frame under the rear panel, so just labeled all that stuff.
Yeah.
And he kept all that stuff together as much as possible.
So you want all replated stuff, I'm sure.
Yeah.
This is fantastic. Oh my god.
That seat. And this is what actually came on the bike. This is an old Corbin seat.
Corbin Gentry.
Not quite the look I was going for.
No. No. It's like the fairings. You see them laying around everywhere.
Yeah, I bet you that seat would go well with one of those fairings.
Yeah. Well, this is the pan we need to use. I want to say, what I would do, let's get this pan powder coated and we'll save the foam, because late 74 and up went to this color foam.
Okay.
So this is correct. So we could just probably wipe this foam off and put a nice cover on her. I've got a guy that's a magician. We'll see if we can polish out that inner fender. If not, I have some really good ones from Japan.
How about time capsule?
Yes, this is a time capsule.
It's a collection of time capsules. So you can see me in my basement looking at all this stuff.
You know, you're not going to have to buy a whole lot. Okay, Brian, what we have here is a big bore kit. Now here's a cylinder, we're just going to do an exchange. So what we've done is we've cleaned all this up really nice. And this cylinder has no broken fins. And this is a standard bore cylinder. And here's this is your cylinder will be perfect for your bike. It's 903 right here. And it takes the O-ring right here. So this is the same cylinder from 74Z1 up through KZ900A, which would be 76 and 77. This is the big bore kit. This is what you want. It comes with this high-tech gasket here. So it's like a two-piece gasket that goes together. That's pretty cool. Here's the base gasket. Now, this is 70 millimeter. Standard Z1 is 66 millimeter. This is total, the best stuff money can buy for this motorcycle. It comes with the rings and everything. And these are very precious because they have them in little velvet bags. That's what the pistons look like. You're almost good enough to put for furniture or something, or your showcase or something. But anyway, this is what's gonna be in your motorcycle. Okay, Brian, we're finally getting ready here to do your wheels here. We're gonna start moving on your bike. So we got everything stashed up here. So now we're gonna unstash it. So I've got five wheels here. I shouldn't be stepping on this one, but I'm going to. So I'm gonna pull your wheels down. And we're gonna kind of see what rims are usable, which ones aren't. So we're gonna get, you got six wheels here to choose from. So we'll pull them down and I'll give you a report here in a few minutes. Okay, thanks. Okay, Brian, I just got these wheels down. All the rims are kind of gooned. Not good enough for what we're trying to accomplish here. You got tire and marks on every one of them, or there's rust. Back here we got tire and marks and stuff like that. So I would say that these are all going to be good. You know, this is, someday we won't call this junk, but today we have to call it junk because it's not nice. But all the rims have issues. Everywhere there's an issue. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna pull these wheels apart where I can get at least one good front hub, and I'll get it powder coated. Now this looks like a good candidate right here, simply because this is where the speedometer drive goes. This feels nice. A lot of them are worn out right here, so the gear won't fit right. So I'm on board with this hub right here because the rim is really gooned anyway. So we're gonna take this apart. I'll get this powder coat for you. And not much we can do with this cap right here because this is dented. I can possibly take it to the polisher. Perhaps he can do something with it. Or maybe this one. I'll go through your caps. Now, on the back right here, this looks like this is a potentially good surface right here. Okay, there's no lines. Doesn't feel like it's deep. So I'll check that out, and all this is nice. So a lot of potential here. Sometimes they bend them right here and stuff, but this is nice. So we'll probably disassemble this. We'll probably use this hub. I'll make sure I'll get you the best one that I can possibly come up with. But anyway, we're probably going to use this hub right here, that hub right there, and I'll try to find you a nice hub cap, and I'll get the polisher to clean it up for me. Got to clean these wheels up. They're gonna clean up a little better, the tires and stuff. But here's your Buchanan stainless steel spokes with your brand new rims, powder coated hub, new bearings, new seal, new tube, everything. This is what you want. Then there's your rear. We had your drum polished. So how nice that is. We bead blasted this, polished this, new bearings, new spokes, new rim, new tire, new tube. And these are V-rated tire. That's good for like 130 mile an hour if that's where you want to go. We got the cam cover. Now this is what we prefer. I was just going to do this on exchange for you if you want. This is vapor blasted with polished ends. This is as close to original as we can go. You can get a full polished job if you like. I don't like it like that, but if you like it like that, that's up to you. But we can go full polish if you wish, or we have the standard setup here. Now, one question, well, that's a question. These are the cam cover bolts. We make these. This is a perfect part that you need that. This is a gasket that we have. We buy these from Japan. K&L Supply. They're kind of on the expensive side. But this we know is good for sure. We have these other gaskets that we sell and kits that people use. This is more of a generic thing. It's made by Vezra. It's okay, but it's really not cool. It's all right, I guess. I don't recommend this. If you don't want it to leak oil, you're better off with that. Now, the next question is, these are the cam cover end plugs. This goes between the cam cover and the cylinder head. These are half moons. This is a set of four. These are billet. These are really cool. We're not having any trouble with them. I have these in silver, or I have them in black. Or you can get the genuine style ones that are reproduced. K&L distributes them here in the States. They're cheaper. This is better, but the other ones are cheaper. So let me know if you like this, or you just want the generic ones. Okay, thanks. Brian, got some good news for you. We are going to open up your motor today and start working on your motorcycle. So we'll give you some details of what's happening. I was kind of looking it over. Of course, we're going to place all the screws and stuff. We'll get this all vapor blasted. We'll get this all blasted, the cam chain tensioner. We'll put some nice new bolts in it. From looks of the wires, you already have a Dyna ignition in it, so that's probably going to be good. Looks like air's in pretty good shape. Looks like, I was wondering how they kept it so nice. I think they painted this. So anyway, we'll get this all taken down to bare cases. Should have it apart today. Getting ready to go to take us to the vapor blaster. We're gonna get rid of all this paint and stuff off here. When this motor was assembled last, there was a broken bolt here on the starter. So we have to fix the broken bolt. That's not trouble. But the rest of it, everything else is good. Nice cases. This is the used pistons and stuff that you had. We're gonna put the Weisco in here. This needed service, wasn't set up very nice. The crankshaft is good. We're going to replace a couple of these bearings here. And then it's a blessing, this bolt here for the shift fork was loose. when we took it apart, this wasn't tightened down even with the lock tab. So, anyway, it's a good thing you didn't ride it a lot, because this would have come out, and then it would have tried to find a home, and it would have had escaped through the gears. So that's a good thing. But the rods are nice. The magnet's nice. Very nice. We're going to put a cam chain in it while we got it down. So we're going to go through all your valves and all your top end stuff and everything. So here's all this stuff. We're going to clean all this stuff up. Unfortunately, we either me or Hilo or Kenny has to clean all this up because we need a cleanup guy. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. So anyway, we're going to start cleaning all this up probably tomorrow. And we'll be setting this stuff out. Now, it looks like you have, I want to say these are Andrew's cams. I mean, you got so, I don't know, you know, they're okay. I'd rather see you run the stock ones, especially since you're going to have stock carburetors and stock pipes. I think it, we can run these, but I think we're better off putting the stock OEM ones, which we have several of. Again, that's your choice, but you got a lot of parts that would be left behind for trading stock, so I think you should put the stock ones in if you're just going to ride it anyway. That's what I would do. And the valves, obviously, are all used, and we'll check those out. Maybe we can use some, maybe we can't. We'll get into that probably tomorrow or so. So I just kind of wanted to show you where we're at with it. The head is nice. There's nothing busted out here or anything like that. And there's no broken fins. So we're going to scrape all this off and make this nice again. We're getting ready to send your stuff out for polishing. We're starting to make some time here. So this, we're going to just polish out as normal. So here's this, and I'll send you some more stuff here in a quick second. Got the frame really smoothed out here pretty good. This is cool. We had to fix in about 5 different places. So here's where the dents were. Right there. It's all pretty nice. And then Hilo had to weld the washers on here to pound these races up because they weren't coming. So anyway, here's your... We're keeping this for scrap metal. However, that's your steering races. If you come to this side of the frame, you can see how nice that looks now. That'll look a lot better once we put the powder coating on it. And then there was a place over here that he did it to too.
Right here.
So this is all pretty good. So I want to say that you have a really nice frame, and we're ready to send the frame to the powder coater. And we're just unpacking the powder coating and stuff that we got. So Hilo did a pretty nice job. I mean, it's not perfect, but it's really nice. Very nice, actually, especially compared to where it was. So you did it there and there, and this is all really nice. This is one of the better frames I've seen. And then he also did some work back here where this was kind of gooned all back here. So this is all perfect now. And next to it is your swing arm. Got the cases back and everything. Hilo just power washed them out and everything. Crank's all lubricated. Rods feel super nice. Bearings feel super nice. Everything feels super nice. Okay, Brian, got a couple options for you. These are the lower legs that we took off your bike. It's kind of, if you like this over polished like that, it's okay. But this is kind of gooned right here. So we would have to send this off to get these scratches out. And it looks like there's some grain, like it's not quite even right here. When they polished them or whatever they did, this is kind of oblonged. Okay, not the end of the world, or you could use them as is. We just want to bring them to your attention. But anyway, this one definitely needs to get the scratches out of it. This is more of the natural finish. This is something that we offer here. This has the new seals, reflectors, everything. This is pretty nice stuff right here. And this is more of the dull finish. This is what we use on the majority of our stuff, but this looks good. This is nice, just a little shinier. Then, we're looking at your shocks right now. This is gooned right here. This is be hard to get those out because this is plastic. This is plastic. But Hilo was telling me that these are bent. And now that I'm looking at them, I can see that they are bent. We're going by this right here. It's a straight line. I could show you with a straight edge if you wished. This one is really bent. We have new shocks. They're reproduction, but we have them in stock. I don't think these are going to function very good because they're bent. And now you can see where this is real close right here, but has a gap right here. Okay. We're open for suggestions. But anyway, see how that's bent right there? Same thing. But whatever you decide, let us know. And we're moving right along. But let us know on the fork right away because Hilo's getting ready to put this together. Now, over here is your lower end of the bike. This is all vapor blasted, all the paint's off. The crankshaft's pretty nice. This is all good. So, all replated bolts. These are not reproduction, these are replated. So, new cam chain, looking good. So we're moving along here, and the painter, I believe, is gonna have your paint ready in a couple of weeks from my son's conversation with him today. So we're moving right along, but I really need to know about these forks ASAP because we're ready to put your chassis together. Because what we do, the main reason why we want to do the chassis right away is because we're all getting older now. It's easier for us to put the bottom end in than it is to put the whole engine in. That way we don't scratch it and all that stuff because we're pretty nervous about scratches. Got the wheel on. Polished carrier, new sprocket. Replated studs. New nuts. Nice locks. This is all replated. New, nice. Pistons are in it. Battery box is in it. We have our Rick's Electric regulator rectifier underneath the battery box as shown. Can't run one without this. This is a nice thing. Nice. Replated washer, jam nut. New hardware. So Hilo is replacing three valves in the head. Nice head. Got all your buckets and everything marked. There's all your springs and stuff. So we're making some good headway here. We're waiting on that paint job. What's going on with the paint job? We need it. We have not got all the parts back from our polisher and stuff, but the bike is rocking and rolling here. And very, very momentarily here, we're gonna start it up for you. It's a pretty nice motorcycle, actually. Okay, gas is on. Nice.
working. High low working. Good. This is pretty good. Just got started up today. We got the paint back. This bike runs nice. Need a little more time, but it's coming. Nice bike. Kind of look it over best you can from what we've got. My wife will take some up close videos and stuff. If there's anything you like and you don't like and all that and all that, let us know. This is pretty cool. Actually, this is really cool. It looks good. I mean, it really looks good. We have to test drive it, and right now is a very, very difficult time to test drive it because it's like 6 degrees outside and about this much snow. So it would probably kill us if we did. But I just want you to look it over and kind of tell us what you think. This is a very nice motorcycle. This is a very, very, very nice motorcycle. I don't know what to say. It runs and everything, but we have no way of test driving it. But I mean, the paint is gorgeous. The polished lower legs are gorgeous. The hubcap is gorgeous. You got the Kenda tires. I mean, this is clean. This is clean. This is very clean. So let me know what you think. We still have a few small things to do to it, but
like
this is very clean. Well, just some small things, like I was going to put a warning decal on the backing plate and stuff like that to make it look nicer and stuff, which we can do. But we'd like to put some time on it. I mean, feel free, you can pick it up now if you like. If you have I would suggest a enclosed trailer or something of that nature. But we think it's done. Man, this is a nice motorcycle. This is nice.
Brian, he says that he does not want to take it on the road because we still have salt on the road. We don't dare do that because then we'll have to wash it and get all the stuff off. And whoa. What a pretty bike. I don't blame you for being anxious. This is such a nice bike. Woo.
Okay, Brian, we're out test driving your bike right now as we speak. We rebuilt this caliper here. This is our caliper here for the dual disc. This is right side only. That's pretty hard to find. This one here is yours, but Hilo says that the body's worn out and we can't get it to hold the seal on the left side.
I changed it twice to see.
He said he changed it up twice, and we can't fix it. So we have to get a different one on there, or you'll have nothing but issues and troubles. So anyway, we're in the process of making it rock and roll right now. So we have no choice but to get you a different one. Okay, I'm sure I got something laying around in the back. That's why we like to ride them a lot. What a wonderful bike. It's great. This is a fantastic bike. You're going to love this. Okay. Well, thanks a lot, Brian, and we'll stay in touch with you. But just another little setback, but it's not the end of the world. Okay.
Brian, I'm out riding your bike today. I got 86 miles on it. Mechanically, it's absolutely 100% perfect. Runs super. No motor noise, no smoke, everything is good, but I have one problem. We had a guy resurface these rotors, we're not sure. But I got noise. When I hit the brakes, I got noise. So we're really not digging that. Here's a noise. So I don't know. Never had that happen before like that. So we'll check it out. But so far, that's the only problem I've had. So we're gonna go and make some adjustments Monday. Maybe I'm gonna try another set of rotors or something. But it's definitely pad to rotor noise, and I don't know what the deal is. First time we ever had this problem. But outside of that, it's a good bike. We'll figure it out. Okay, I hope you like it, and I'm having a blast on this thing. This is cool. Okay. Okay, Brian, we're working here on Sunday, and we just got your caliper half back from the powder coater. Hopefully this one's a lot better than what you had. So the other one, the body was worn out. So we just got this back, and we're going to assemble this week, and the weather's getting nice out. It was like 50-some degrees today, so that's happening. So we'll be riding it soon. Okay, thanks a lot.
Nice. Did you restore it all? It's, I mean, you did it all work?
Yeah. Everything but the paint. We don't know how to paint.
That's awesome. Paint looks really good.
Yeah. There's a 78 right there. The blue one. One that says historical on it.
Oh, KZ1000. Wow, that's super sharp.
Are you looking to buy one of these or something?
Oh, we're just, we have all the parts for one.
Oh.
Over the course of like 10 years, bought almost everything brand new.
You got it for free?
Yeah, I got it for free from a lady who was almost buying a Harley like 20 years ago.
Whoa.
And it was all original. It just been sitting in the garage for 15 years and still is all just surface rust everywhere.
Wow.
So over the course of the last, I don't know, over the course of 10 years.
When eBay was born.
Yeah.
We got the bug.
Yeah, so we have all the parts that we put it back together.
You have a couple of them up front. This is the 76 custom.
So is this your personal collection, or do you sell these, or?
Some of them are mine, a couple of them are customers.
Oh, okay.
That's a cool one here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, a good one. This is from Texas. There's a pretty nice 75.
Oh, yeah.
There's that blue.
This thing looks cool.
Sweet. Dual disc. What year is that?
74. With dual disc front brakes. Not bad.
Very neat.
Sounds like a process of moving these outside too.
Thank you.
bet ours is in like 100 boxes.
Should have brought it down.
Yeah, should have brought it down.
Yeah, I imagine that'd be a lot of hours to have that, pay to reassemble it.
Could have gotten them that way.
If I know a guy, I could put it together.
We're taking it home.
Oh yeah.
We are.
We're gonna buy that.
This is the Z1. It is.
What? Get out of here. Is it really?
Is it?
That's all your shit.
That's all the stuff.
Are you fucking with me?
No.
It's not, since everyone's taping it, right?
Oh, that's awesome. Isn't that cool? Go for a ride.
I gotta change shoes then. I don't want responsibility of.
I personally drove it 188 miles. And
I'm not sure yet.
It runs really good. You're gonna love this motorcycle.
That's pretty cool to me.
Wow. When did you bring all this stuff down here?
2 years ago.
Holy crap.
I was on the waiting list for 2 years. And then I got it here 2 years ago.
And then how long did it take you?
Over 100.
We should get a picture of the waiting list, or at least show it to him.
Yeah. I can remember. I was talking to him. He's like, "You should just get on the waiting list." I'm like, "All right."
That's the best color.
It's unbelievable. I can't believe it's assembled.
Isn't that the most beautiful 75 you've ever seen in your life?
That's really cool.
This is totally over the top.
We got to put it in the sunlight.
Yeah.
So what else did you have to get yourself that we didn't have?
Just little things here and there. Now you guys got something to go home and play with.
That's unbelievable.
It's a good thing you held on to it.
This is reserve. I always run them on a reserve just because. I don't know much. It has to be a little bit.
So there's no Indian you're buying.
This is it.
This is it.
It's a man with an Indian shirt.
Yeah. They were all.
This is an old man that, the same number as my son on the back, number 35. And he helped my son out a little bit racing.
Same number as you and Grandpa too.
Yeah, actually was.
So you have the whole motor redone and everything?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a video on it and everything.
There's probably a dozen YouTube videos on the process throughout the year.
How was the motor when you took it apart?
It was okay. It was all stock. I mean, it wasn't beat. But we put a. It's now a 1015 instead of a 903.
But 903 was original displacement.
Oh, okay. I got
now it's got a 1015 kit, so it gives it more. Yeah, a lot more. So if you're going up a hill at 50 mile an hour, you crack the throttle and it's going to just keep pulling.
Yeah.
And I, you know, I've had it pull up to like 110 or so, and it will go more.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not the, I think those days are in our past.
Triple
25 years.
Wow.
It was, and when we got it was still in the Kawasaki box.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I bought that, I think it was $550. I paid for that 20 years ago, I think. It was brand new.
Like, okay. Because her and her husband were going to buy a Harley. He was getting it that weekend. So I went to the house, and she goes, so just show up at 2 o'clock with the trailer. So I went in there, and just her kids were home. And so we backed up, and the kids said, oh, yeah. So we loaded it up, and I'm like, is your dad or mom going to be home soon? So the dad comes home first. He had no idea. His wife was giving away this bike. It just sat there for 15 years, and so it had this nice coat. It wasn't
patina on it, yeah.
It was just this nice rust everywhere, light rust, and then we took it home, and then I had this crazy idea of stripping it all down and bagging it.
Yeah. It was assembled when we got it. Then he took it all apart, and you saw it. I mean, you went through little post-it notes inside of a Ziploc bag, a thousand of them.
Yeah.
It's so awesome. I'm just glad that the day finally got here. 4 years of waiting and 25 years of sitting in the basement. So, and got to pull off a good spot. We'll be right back.